that we've brought in all of our individual assets, we're going to actually bring in our clouds that we prepared earlier. So just import and locate in our images our cloud PNG that we created earlier to have a transparent background. And then we'll just rotate that into place and scale that down. Make sure it's above our background image. And then we can position that into place. And we're going to create a simple scrolling cloud effect with a couple of duplicates of that. So if we just duplicate that cloud, and then we want to bring one that goes above our composition. So then it feels like we've got a little bit more depth happening. And then we can scale that down a bit as well. And then to create a simple scrolling effect for our clouds, we can group those. And then we'll put them into a folder together. We'll label that clouds. And we want to set the behavior by coming down, turning on our behavior builder and adding a trigger. And we want to set the trigger to start. So when we open our AR app experience, we'll automatically start our animation. And we want to create an action that is to move. So we're going to move across this X axis. And if we just select that, and then we know we want to move across the X axis. And if we just try 1 centimeter, and we want a pretty slow duration of 10 seconds. And you can just play a preview here. And you can see that it's a slow moving cloud effect we've got there. And then we can preview that. And you can start to see we have some animation happening there. Then the next behavior we want to set is for our ship's wheel, and we want to create a tap function. So when users are interacting with the experience on their app, they'll be able to tap this ship's wheel and cause it to rotate. So making sure that our ship's wheel center point pivot is set, we're going to come to our triggers, and by creating a tap trigger, we then want our action to be a rotate. And if we just check in our properties over here, we can rotate and make sure that's our axis we want to rotate on. So in the corresponding settings in our trigger, we're going to set Z to rotate 360 degrees, giving us one full rotation. And then we're going to change our duration to 3 seconds and leaving our easing to in and out. And to get this to loop infinitely, we want to up the count to 2 and then check infinite and back and forth. And then we can preview how that animation works. So we get a little back and forth motion as if the ship's steering. For the next behavior we want to create is a reveal. So we want our objects to come in from a zero point, and some will scale into place and others will fade on. So for the first example, we want to select our background image of Cape Disappointment and then come down to our behaviors and set a start trigger. And for this time, we want our action to be a show. So now that we've added that, we can come down and we're going to change our effect to fade. So it's just going to affect the transparency. And we want to set our duration to be 1 second. And we don't want that to loop infinitely, so we'll leave that unchecked. And then just be sure to hide our image when you go to publish your project, so it'll recognize that it's hidden from the beginning. And then the show will take place to reveal our image. So if we view in our preview here, you can see that that image will fade on. So then you can move through the rest of your assets, and you can group certain sections and create start triggers to be on the groups or individual elements, depending on how you want your scene to animate in with timing. you can have multiple elements reveal at the same time, or pace it out to have a sequence. And you're also able to open the working file that has been included in the project files, the tattoos2life.real file, and that has all of the working behaviors and triggers that you can come in and check out for yourself and get a better idea of how these are all constructed. So these are all set, and all the behaviors and triggers are located down here.